It's the way it says. September 11th. I remember exactly where I was. I remember what I was doing. I remember who I was with. I didn't see the first one hit. I saw it on the news, saw the building burning. And I saw the second one hit. Live. My son had got his hand hurt in Pee Wee football. He was up there to get his hand put back together. They had to put pins in it. Pee Wee football. Anyway. He was already back, or going back when it happened. My mother-in-law wouldn't, for whatever reason. First I was like, man, what kind of movie is this? This is... And I was like, man, this can't be really happening. And I was like, this is Islam. They did this. Somehow or another, they did this. And I found out I was right. A bunch of the stuff doesn't add up, I know. Deal was with the Pentagon. That doesn't matter. This isn't about any of that. This is about the way I felt, the way I still feel. The guys that took the planes and did the deed did it because of their religious beliefs. Their religious beliefs dictate bad things for other people that don't believe the same as them. Now, I don't ascribe to the pacifist form of Christianity that almost everybody else does. I believe that shotgun preacher might be on something. Or machine gun. Is it machine gun preacher? We don't fight amongst ourselves or each other. That's the rule. I don't know if anybody will ever convince me. That Islam is anything other than a religion of hate. They actually view anybody outside their religion as less than human. But then again, not all of them. But the ones we're fighting do. There's guys, Americans, that hold their butts to some of the guys that read the whole Quran themselves and didn't listen to a guy who came to power as the Ayatollah. On a foundation of hate. Since the 60s. The 60s. They've been trying to figure out how to shut us down. And by shut us down, I mean end our existence. Nine 11's the biggest one. It's nowhere close to all of them. Y'all don't forget what brought us together. It wasn't the deaths. It wasn't the horrible images. It was the fact that we finally knew who our enemy was. And so many started crying when they found out that when you fight an enemy, it costs you. And then we had others that started hiding behind, oh, this isn't a real war about anything other than this, this, and this. Really. So, you know, we didn't go there and start shooting old boys for cutting people's heads off, drilling people's elbow joints out, stoning girls to death, women. Sodomizing little boy. That's not who we're fighting. That's not who we went to war with. I thought that's who we went to war with. Rabbit dog's rabbit dog. We finally know where he's living. Every doubt in my mind about Donald Trump as our new president ended the day a MOAB fell on a mountainside. Should just been more than one. Just keep making them, keep dropping them. I can hear a plane flying over in the background right now. It can carry one. Might even be able to hold two. Build them and drop them. Yeah. 9/11 ended coexistence for me. It was never going to work anyway. Yeah. YouTube probably knocked this off, but maybe a few people see it. That's really how I feel. Did you know that there's enough evidence in the Quran to convert to Christianity? One of the guys that's running for his life out there every day, spreading the word, the gospel. He came to the full knowledge of Jesus Christ from the Quran. He's done calling himself a Muslim anymore. He doesn't even count Muhammad as a prophet, because Muhammad never talked about Christ. It's in the part of the Quran before he started opening his mouth. God, Yahweh, his son, Jesus, Yeshua. That's the one. The one that says, if you want to do whatever, go do it. That's up to you. You're the one choosing hell. That's my God. The one that says, if you decide to come home to me, I'll welcome you. I'll help you. I'll help you have a better life. I'll help you learn to love people. That's my God. You know, the one that teaches me to pray for Islam. I pray every day that they convert and that they're saved and they come to the full knowledge of Christ. That's where it ends. If they choose not, or if they're going to choose not, I pray that they fall and they fall quickly. You can't pray no better thing for someone than that they find Christ. I don't think it's that wrong to pray that somebody be ended before they have more to answer for. That's me, 9/11. Don't forget. That was hate attacking us. We have an enemy. Don't forget who they are.